This is the come up show where that feel good music lives. Real recognized, real big show going down tonight at the Outback Shack. Grant and Alok, you should already know them by now. And if you don't know, check them out.
I mean, no consequence when you playing with the fire. Move to the left, man, no fuss, no fight. You're living on the low or you're climbing on the rise. Recognizing the stakes
what
still
is
high.
Grant and Alok? Who is Grant and Alok? What is Grant and Alok?
It's a project. It started as a project. It was an experiment. I decided to try to just free myself from what you think you're supposed to do and do what you always wanted to do. And that's what I did. I teamed up with my boys, my brother, Ofield, and Catalyst, who's the co-producer with me and also the keyboardist for us. And Dub B, he's the bass player, and I got Aaron on the drums. And all these guys have different backgrounds, you know what I mean? I was a hip-hop kid growing up, and I was trying to envision what kind of hip-hop I'd love to listen to, and I couldn't think of anyone that was making it. And I can't believe how long it's taken me to think, well, then I'll make it. You know what I mean? It's just crazy as I think back in retrospect.
It's about time you get grown. I suppose always looking for a new home.
It's very important for you guys to make sure that the live show is maintained in the album. When people, you don't want people to be disappointed when they see your live show and they buy the CD and they're not happy, or you wanted to maintain that, and you don't want to be one of those type of guys that are, you know, why, please tell me about that.
Well, you know what? It hurts me when people in general say hip-hop's out now. And then I go to a hip-hop show. Yeah, what's up, man? Yo, what's up, man? I'm MC such and such, and this is my man right here. We just gonna hit it up. Okay, yo, kick the beat, man. Yo, man, what the fuck, man? I'm gonna fucking say, man. Hey, what you sick when you doing what I'm doing, man? What the fuck is going on? And I'm watching this going, man, this sucks. This sucks. It's got to be on the same level, the live show and the music, the recorded music. And that's why it's called recording arts. To record music is an art form. And some cats got it like that, but they can't hold down the stage, and they work hand in hand. You got to make it hand in hand. So it's very important for me that if you're checking out my show, go check out the CD. You're gonna get the same love and intensity. Or if you listen to the CD first, come to the show, you're gonna get the same intensity. It's very important to us as a band and as a traveling group and artist. Yeah.
I could take that back.
Do you adjust your performances somehow? Do you change it up? Are you like, okay, this is a jazz show, you know what I mean? And average age is going to be probably 40, 50, 60, and this is a hip-hop show, 18, 20, 30, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
You know what? We don't make a set list. Mm-hmm. I mean, for people out there that understand the set list and performing, we don't create a set list. We vibe out what track should go next. So when we hit the stage, we all look at each other and we figure out what we're gonna start with. So tonight, you know, I felt like kazoo was gonna be the one. So I turn around and said, let's start with, I play my kazoo and we roll that. And they don't know where we're gonna go from here. We just vibe it out. So whether we're playing a jazz festival, a folk festival, a rock festival, a reggae festival, a hip-hop festival, and we've played all those, it's basically a turnaround and I call it out because I gotta feel the crowd. If the crowd's not feeling what I'm doing, which is rare, then I gotta switch it up.
Seems like musicians now are going to, there is no, like, you know, one genre. They're playing around everything, and not only the musicians, the fans, you know. I'll ask anybody nowadays, what do you listen to? And the most common answer I get is everything.
Yeah.
How, what happened? What made that happen? Where did that change? And what do you think influenced that?
The iPod changed it, man. You know, I remember I had a Discman, and you know, I had like one of the hottest Discmans, man.
Probably a Sony one, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a Sony, one of those shock resistant.
G-Shock, remember that.
Yeah. I was rolling that with that. I was on the bus in Peg City, and one of my boys came up to me and he shows me this square thing with a circle on it. He's like, dude, man, you got to get off that Discman. Like, why? I like to listen to albums, man. I like to listen to an album from beginning to end. He's like, man, I'm bringing 10, 20, 30 albums in this one thing. So I remember looking at this going, okay, so this is the future. All right. I remember I was an analog kid from way back. So for you to show me this digital piece of work, it took me a while to get into it. But now I got my own little radio station on my iPod and it plays every genre of music. When I hit shuffle, it will go from boom, jazz to hip hop to rock to whatever, and it's my iPod, it's my music that I want to listen to, and it's full of genres and full of artists. The iPod did it, man. Now everyone's listening to everything. If they like a single, they'll go on wherever and get that single, and they won't. The albums, I make albums, so I want you to buy albums. Please, still buy albums, please.
Hey, hey.
Metropolis is Burning, released in May 2009. And I would say you guys are getting great response from that. You probably got tons of new fans from that. What does that title mean?
It's pretty simple, but it's how it went down. I was hanging out with my cousin, and he's older. He's an older cousin. What's up, Colin? Anyway, we were talking about green initiatives, and we were talking about recycling and how cities really need to educate everyone in the city to clean things up and start taking care of the planet before it just goes to waste. And a friend of ours had said, you know what, I don't really believe in it. I don't really want to recycle. I was like, I couldn't believe this. A human still feels that way. Like, he will throw something on the ground and still walk away from it. He will, you know, he will keep the water running and not even think about it. Like, those kind of things. And I remember, I told him, man, look outside your window, man. Look outside your window. And it was summertime, and, you know, I'm like, look at this community. You know what I mean? Like, it's a community. We all got to do what we got to do, man. Metropolis is burning, guy. And he looked at me. He's like, what? I'm like, Metropolis is burning up, man. But I was so heated because he couldn't listen to me. And he was like, man, that's all bullshit, man. Recycling is bullshit. God, look out your window. Metropolis is burning up there. I'm like, all right. That's the title of the album. I don't even know what happened then. It just came out. Came out like a fart in the wind. It came out. What are you looking at?